Rising from the depths of the San Francisco Bay is the newest architectural crown jewel of Northern California. The new Bay Bridge, which connects San Francisco and Oakland, is now open for business, and what a sight it is to see. Roughly 280,000 vehicles travel the east and westbound lanes each day. It's now the widest bridge in the U.S., with five lanes in each direction. This is 6 years' worth of round-the-clock time-lapse video of the new 2.2-mile east span. They built it right next to the old bridge. The project cost $6.4 billion. This is earthquake country. The great San Francisco quake of 1906 wiped out 80% of the city. The Old Bay Bridge opened in 1936, and it sits in the worst possible spot, right between two major fault lines, the San Andreas and the Hayward Faults. And the worst case scenario happened October 17th, 1989. You may remember this scene from the Loma Prieta quake. A 230-ton section of the old bridge collapsed. Traffic came to a halt for more than a month.
How big of a danger zone is this?
It's a major concern.
How close are we to one of those fault lines now?
We are very close. If you look out at the East Bay Hills, the Hayward Fault basically runs right along the East Bay Hills. Just past the Golden Gate Bridge sits the San Andreas Fault.
The Bay Bridge is a stunning engineering feat for another reason, something that's not visible at first glance. Crumple zone technology. Until now, crumple zones have mostly been used in cars. They absorb the energy by controlled deformations. So engineers say the new bridge won't collapse, even in a powerful quake. Marwan Nader is one of the project's architects. He was a grad student at UC Berkeley during the 89 quake.
I was at a supermarket. We all felt a jolt. People started talking a little bit about rumors, and everybody started panicking.
Where would you want to be if a big quake hits?
The safest place would be on the top of the tower of this bridge. It'll be one heck of a joyride, but it will be a safe one.
Here's what Nader is talking about. This is an animation of how the bridge responds to a major quake. The engineering community considers the innovations game changers. The first one is the shear link beams. They're inside the 525-foot tall tower on the self-anchored suspension bridge.
The shear link beam is the heart and soul of how we made the single tower work. Those link beams actually reduce the forces that go onto the bridge. Everything is elastic.
This animation shows how the beams allow the four legs of the tower to move independently. The beams take the energy by bending and deforming.
The stiffer the structure, the more rigid it is, the more forces the earthquake applies on it. The more flexible the structure is, the less forces go into it.
Just watch your step, watch your head, things are sticking out.
We're now deep in the bridge's bowels to see another innovation firsthand. To get there, we have to walk and climb through a mini city of steel.
Wow, you weren't kidding, huh?
We're hundreds of feet above the bay, but still under the traffic.
Oh, wow.
And it's basically a big steel dowel. Again, this is one of those sacrificial elements where we want this to be damaged in order to protect the bridge deck itself.
You are looking at one of 20 hinge pipe beams strategically placed inside the bridge.
In the event of an earthquake, this will move back and forth like an accordion.
They work horizontally, bending and contorting while allowing the rest of the bridge to move.
And that's where the seismic energy is going to be concentrated. So by designing sections of the bridge to fail, that will protect the more structural elements. After an earthquake, workers can go up, inspect them, determine if there is any damage. If there is, it can be repaired or cut out and replaced.
I'm standing on another innovation. Below me are battered piles. Each one is 8.5 feet in diameter and 300 feet long. And there are 160 of them buried deep within the bay to allow for greater stability of the bridge during a major quake.
These are new to bridges, but battered piles have long been used on oil rigs in the ocean. They stand at an angle to allow movement, rather than up and down. Wow. earthquake crumple zone technology is now being used in structures across the San Francisco Bay Area. So the future looks bright and safe in earthquake country. If they can build a safe bridge in the middle of two major faults, the thinking is anything can be safe.
Do you see a day when all new buildings and structures would implement some sort of this technology?
We'd hope. You'd like to think that cities, when a large earthquake comes, it would be an inconvenience rather than a disaster. Mm. And I think these rocking frames is one solution.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology is a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
TechKnow's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of TechKnow on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.